So the real estate market has been kind of upside down lately, and you might have noticed maybe you're not getting quite as many gigs. Yes, there are some issues with inventory and sellers being hesitant to put their houses on the market, fewer buyers out there that are now not qualified because of higher interest rates to make offers on houses, but if you are slow, I'm going to give you some tips here that are used by myself and other pro real estate photographers because we've helped to insulate ourselves from these down markets where we still stay busy. So this is something that we've had to do for decades. So this is something that's always been around for years and years. And that's because we insulate ourselves similar to what other businesses do to protect ourselves from these fluctuations in the market. There are always fluctuations in the market. Being a down market right now means nothing because when we were deep in the pandemic, wasn't everybody saying, well, yeah, there's a lot of houses that are going on the market, but they're just flying off the shelves when the pandemic first started. So why would you need a photographer? Why would they need to hire me for this? Well, 2009, the big housing crash, there was all kinds of upside downness that was going on. And even between that and the pandemic, there were ups and downs in the market. So the best way to protect yourself from these ups and downs is insulating yourself by what I call the protective overflow concept. So with this protective overflow, what you do is you protect certain slots within your schedule. Now, there's an approach to doing this that you have to be prepared for so that you can get the type of clients to fill in. Let me explain this and just bear with me here for just a second. The idea of an overflow to begin with, doesn't matter what the market is, this is just a standard scheduling thing when it comes to service industries like real estate photography. And what we normally do is you want to be able to keep a few slots open the next week. So let's say that you're getting calls this week and your people are trying to schedule stuff for next week. So let's say that you've got, let's say, 10 slots that you keep open. So doing pro photography work for real estate, that would be typical because you'd only do maybe 2 houses a day and basically make the same as HDR photographers running out to get 5 or 10 houses a day. So anyways, talking about the pro real estate market, 10 is plenty enough to make really good money for a week. So let's say that you do have that 10 slotted, but 7 of those slots are already filled up for next week. That means you have 3 slots open. At this point, if you get a call from a new agent, someone you've never worked with, maybe they found you on Google or through social media, you probably don't want to take them on because a week out, you might have one of your star clients call and say, "Can you fit me in?" So what you want to do is keeping that open, you know the inevitability of your clients usually calling and saying, yes, can you fit me in? Can I do this? When you're talking that far out. So what you can do for the overflow is you would say, well, I can put you into the next week after that. So you're starting to already overflow. You're starting to get where you're at 75% or more capacity of your schedule for the following weeks. You overflow that into the next. But this is where the concept comes in down markets. What will happen is, instead of your star clients necessarily getting you those 7 gigs a week, 2 weeks ahead of time for every week, well, you're gonna maybe get 3 or 4. So that's where the overflow, you can start filling in that with the newer clients. Well, then you say, well, how do I get those newer clients then to fill those empty spaces? What will happen in normal up markets or normal to up markets, when everybody's calling real estate photographers to get them out there for their gigs, is you're gonna find that those real estate agents, the new ones that are calling you to fill in those slots, are gonna be turned down because you'd have to overflow them into a week later. Well, they weren't really interested in you or your work, they just found a real estate photographer, so they'll just move on and find someone else, and that's okay. Your star clients are the ones that are dedicated to keep you a sustainable business. That's why you didn't fit other people in when your slots were almost filled up. But when those star clients aren't filling up those slots as much, then you can take on the work from those other one-off type agents, I like to call it. So that's what happens in markets like this, where I'm getting a lot of one-off clients, and that happens with a lot of pros too, because we have now more openings, so that keeps you busy. But there's a lot more to that. The biggest thing to be able to make sure that happens is one simple rule. It is so often overlooked. I talk about it time and time again here on my YouTube channel, and that's that if you want to attract as many clients as possible, it isn't through Facebook ads or Instagram or whatever. There's only one thing that really will stand out, and that's the quality of your work. and because you have to show that you're better than everybody else in your area. Otherwise, well, why would your star clients stay with you, and what would make you stand out to have you at the top of the list to be called by other real estate agents and other people that want real estate photos, whether it's for the listing market or for builders, designers, whatnot? You want to stand out above the rest. And if you want to do that, I've said it before, you got to get good. You got to get really good. So during the down market, if you don't have an overflow effect hitting yet and you're really sparse on getting some of those shoots, now's the perfect time to start getting really, really good. It's time to practice. It's time to learn. So as you know, I've got my online course for interior real estate photography that can help you with that. I've got a link to that down in the description for this video, and I've got a whole series of books on real estate photography as well. Now's the perfect time to, yes, work through your skill set, learn the trade to your best of your ability, and make sure that you can practice and really show that you do stand out. Because here's the next thing when it comes to making sure that you can fill up those empty slots is don't just be targeting real estate agents. Remodel companies, builders, designers, stagers, there are a lot of people that want to have real estate photography work, but they don't know good real estate photographers. So now's the time also, if you can show that you can do pro level work, like I show in my course and in my books, if you can show that you can do pro level work, you will attract pro level clients. Those are outside of the real estate listing market. So you can start contacting them. If you can show pro work, and just write a quick email, find out who works there, even stop by, show them some of your work, say, hey, in case you need to have for your next ads, I'm a real estate photographer, I live close by, yada, yada, yada. And like I talk in my business techniques book on finding that local lure for a couple agents to start with, that's also a good way also to start attracting clients within the listing market. But another thing that's often overlooked is that sometimes real estate photographers get overly excited about going out and getting clients when they're not ready. And I can't state this enough, just how important this is that if you just started a business, I don't care what it is, even if it was a restaurant, massage parlor, whatever it is, you're gonna take a loss your first year. And why? Because you're gonna come out of the gate and you're gonna suck. You're not gonna be good. I don't care what it is that you do. I was the same way. All of us that have done real estate photography were that way when we look back at our work. And one thing I can tell you is that you need to get at least 100 shoots under your belt. I know that may seem high, but it isn't. I'll explain why in a second. You need to get at least 100 shoots under your belt before you start targeting luxury markets and also the pro market of getting into architectural photography or getting into working with builders, designers, remodel companies, all that. Because 100 shoots is nothing. When you're doing pro work, and let's go back to that 10 shoots a week, just 10 shoots a week, that's all that you would do. Well, you can see that that's 500 shoots a year if you stayed busy. If you were just in the 9 month area of that, you'd still be in hundreds of shoots a year. So during your first year of expected loss running your real estate photography business, having 100 shoots won't take you very long. It should take you maybe a year. Now, how do you get those shoots and how do you work your skill set up? Obviously, yes, I've got my course, I've got my books, but you also shouldn't be targeting the high-end clients yet. Start slow, start near the bottom. Do research in your area, find through your listings, use Zillow, Realtor.com or whatever, and find listings that have terrible pictures. Reach out to those agents if you're just starting out in real estate photography. Let them know that, hey, I'm just starting out in real estate photography. I live really close by to where these listings are. You can even state the address. And tell them I'd be willing to work out a deal if I could gain some experience shooting some of your properties. Don't give them a price. Don't give them a percentage or discount through the email. Just leave that open so you can open the door for a conversation. So that's a topic for another time on really building up clients when you're first starting your business. But in down markets, you have to remember that you need to concentrate on the overflow effect. You need to make sure that you're good enough so that you can attract a broad range of clients and that you will keep and maintain and sustain the constant work for a certain group of star clients, and then let the other overflow be able to be filled up on an as-needed basis for new clients. And also, and I've said this many times before, don't be sending out email blasts, don't be paying for Facebook ads and all this, unless you just want to get one-off clients, because that's all you're going to get. The people, the real estate agents who are gonna open an email and look for a real estate photographer and find you that way haven't had listings yet. If they have, maybe they've had one or two. You don't want those type of clients necessarily unless they're gonna be the overflow to fill in. Your star clients are people that have been doing this a long time and they already have another photographer. You have to convince them that you're better than what they have. That's easy enough once you build up your pro skill set. And another thing is be diversified. So real estate photography, just photos, that's fine. But what about drone? What about video? What about virtual tours? What about virtual staging? All that stuff is important to start building up your skill set. And that can also keep you busy. Pointing to this example here, an example for this, is that I have remodel companies that I shoot for where now they like to have me do more virtual staging. Now, they've got very flexible schedules, so when I'm down and I don't have as many shoots, I can then do more virtual staging for them, and here's a key point, it's an opportunity to upsell. So to be able to tell them when you see an opportunity, hey, you know what I could do for this instead? And give them some other options that will give you more work without being blatant about it. But normally, if you were real busy, yeah, you'd want to be able to satisfy a lot of clients, so you wouldn't be, you'd just be doing the bare minimum or a little bit above that. It's still a good job, but you wouldn't be necessarily making more suggestions. Here's your opportunity to do that, because in a down market, your client may also want a little added marketing boost. So that's the sellability. It's, if everybody's busy, it's hard to do an upsell to anybody. When they're not, if you can show that you, what you can do can provide value to them so that they can get more business, so that they can make more money, then you're sure to also get that type of reciprocation as well. And always remember that word of mouth is king. So you want to be able to have a good reputation, which also says not just, oh, I've shot for 500 realtors that used me one time. You want realtors that know other realtors that are very well engaged. Those are your star clients. And by providing professional level work with professional results and professional customer service, then following these steps, you should be able to keep yourself busy no matter what the market fluctuations will be.